U.S. Border Patrol figures show a 47% decrease in apprehensions since 2009. However, migrant deaths in the desert continue at a steady pace, and the Tucson sector has the highest numbers. Producer Luis Carrion from KUAT in Tucson has an update from the Pima County Medical Examiner's Office.
The international border between Mexico and the U.S. can be a contentious place. And since immigration and border protection policies were implemented in the 1990s, thousands of remains of men, women, and children have been recovered on the U.S.-Mexico border.
We've been kind of the hotbed for this for, about 10 years, especially with the death aspect of it.
Dr. Gregory Hess heads the Pima County Office of the Medical Examiner. As the chief medical examiner in Pima County, it's his job to provide accurate and timely death investigations for the county.
This is the dental restoration here. This we did for DNA. Essentially, in the state of Arizona, it's a medical examiner system. There's no coroners, and counties are responsible for death investigation in Arizona. Pima County includes Tucson and a big chunk of the border, and we do quite a bit of work for other counties that are smaller and don't have their own medical examiner office.
According to Dr. Hess, having such a big chunk of the U.S.-Mexico border fall under the jurisdiction of his office means that migrant deaths account for much of his work.
The freshest numbers I have in my mind are the ones I compiled at the end of 2011. So at the end of 2011, we had recorded 1,911 migrant deaths since 2001. And we actually had identified almost 1,200 of those. So we do end up identifying more people than we don't. Mm-hmm. But still, this is just so many. I mean, nobody else has this problem.
Migrant deaths peaked in 2010 when 230 bodies were recovered in the desert. Border Patrol has reported a significant drop in apprehensions this year, but the number of bodies recovered by the Pima County Medical Examiner's Office are on track to match the 184 body yearly average.
Do they have any tattoos? Have they had any surgeries before? Any dental work that's distinctive? So those things we can try to match with the remains that we have to see if we can identify them. If we can't, then we can always try to resort to DNA.
According to Dr. Hess, his office has worked to expedite the process of identification and delivery of remains to the appropriate parties.
We've tried to be more aggressive about releasing remains when we're done with them and trying to find incentives for people responsible for, burial of unidentified or indigent remains to come and get them quicker.
According to Dr. Hess, the sheer number of bodies that come through this facility has created storage problems for his office, a situation that is unique to the border dynamic of Pima County.
2005 was the first year that we ran out of space in our cooler. So our indoor cooler holds about 120 people, which is actually quite a bit. So we exceeded that in 2005. We had to bring in a refrigerated truck. Built this outdoor cooler that holds 142, which we exceeded a couple times in subsequent years.
No other medical examiner has the problem of dealing with so many migrant deaths. These are unidentified bodies that are recovered from the desert far from families, friends, and the communities that can help identify who they are.
So essentially, this is a male. We don't know who it is. That's why it says John Doe. This death occurred. We found these remains in 2012.
Dr. Hess says the current migration dynamic along the border has increased the workload for his office tremendously. And he says the problem is complex, and any foreseeable solution remains elusive.
Clearly, if there wasn't an economic incentive for people to cross, they wouldn't do so. That sounds basic. How do you fix that is a big question. Other people, would prefer to build sort of a, Great Wall of China type situation and physically prevent people from getting across the desert, and perhaps that would be effective, although, likely people would find other ways if that were there in some fashion.
Dr. Hess says human migration, both legal and illegal, has taken place before around the world. And for the time being, Pima County is at the epicenter of a major historical event. But he says at some point, things will have to change.
And for us anyway, we're just going to keep working as we have been until we suddenly stop finding bodies.